So it was a big stream. And all that fresh water, the foam, there's a little branch over there that's catching the water, there's foam building up. So that environment puts you in accord with what Allah say. Remember, they trying to send you signs and you act off their signs. You go into the hills and you seeing the natural signs. Now, if I were to go 5 or so more years before that, that's a saving force. Because suppose you just ate your food and you prayed and you sit there and they sent you all of this and you came in contact, they're feeding you. Not only food, but environment, right? And if you do it too long, you begin to act off of. They can produce stress and they can produce other, but when you're hitting them hills every day, and you hit the top of them hills and you can see for miles, you go one way and you can see beautiful lakes and everything, hey, that's an environment that you're producing for yourself. You're determining how you feel today by what? The trail I run, what I'm gonna see on that trail, right? If it's March, like now, the trees are all blooming, there's a few wild plums and berries, and you know all the trails. You know the Mayberries. The Mayberries is the ones that get a lot of sun right there, and you can start eating them. You can run in the trail, and you don't buy no berries from the store. You stop and eat you some berries and keep right on running. And then you know what is September and October, they're in the shade. All the big eucalyptus and pine trees, they're shady. Yeah, those berries don't get big blue and red till October or even September and October. You know where these plums on a tree, they get ready, man, them boys gonna be ready in April. Some gonna be ready in May. Crab apple trees, they ain't gonna be ready to way up in October and stuff like that. In other words, you're not susceptible to their environment. They're producing a little environment, but you're more susceptible to the environment you produce. Your physical program, we know, everybody been in good shape though, your physical fitness program determines how you're going to feel that day. By the weight you're going to lift, the trail you're going to run, right? Your workout, even with dumb stuff happening, determines how you're going to feel more than anything else. You're learning to produce your own environment. The longer you do it, the better you get. That's why we're talking about physical fitness today. Make use of your health before becoming sick. So we know the literature is clear. Habits will determine your future. Habits, the foods you eat, the kind of things you sleep on, the things you deal with will determine almost everything about you. So habits determine your future. We talked before about not only physical fitness habits, but psychological habits. This is one that's good. Do you see the big picture? It has over here, living on purpose. Take decisive act, consistent persistence. That's what you want, confidence factor, building excellent relation. But down here it says, it's not hocus pocus, it's all about focus. What that means, what does the shaitan try to do? He deceives you and he diverts you. his main two activities is he's a liar. He deceives people, right? And he tries to divert you, get you off your thing. So the greatest saving force for you, for I, is we stay focused on what we're doing. So whatever they do, that's fine. But I'm not focusing on what you're talking about. We'll get into that a little bit later. Your habits will determine your future. We talked quite a while back about habits, the habit of, that they say 90% of your life is based on habits. Do you know what I mean? Even getting money, saving money, wasting money. They said those are habituals. So 90% of the money you have is based on habits. And if there's a few things that you do in life, then that means 90% of your life is fine. One of the guys, this is Brian Tracy. This is a white guy. I watched him grow old. This is from about, I would say, it's definitely early 80s. This is about thinking big, da 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 da. But one thing he taught his people, you have to say it so many times every day. I like myself. I like myself. You know what I thought? I said, man, if white people have to do that, good God Almighty, then a Negro have to, that's all he can say all day. Either subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, and I like myself. Right? All the heroes look like him, all the books are about them, right? And the human being has a problem liking themselves. The first thing that they're taught in Hollywood, you're okay, you're fine. And like yourself. Like yourself now the way you are, but draw that picture of the way you want to be. And then move your becoming person. Now all that stuff is actually true. Becoming. Yeah. That's how you do in your life. What do I want to look like in the future? Physically. In the near future. Well, you get a physical fitness program, you can look like. That's what bodybuilding is about. And you can get just about the body that you want. Now, in some cases, it won't work. You will always build your body. You know some of them guys with a big behind sticking up, they got a big belly like this? I used to wonder why Charlie Choo Choo Johnson, he was from Sacramento, he was in the joint, he was a heavyweight champion. He could outrun anybody. He had his butt sticking up in there, tummy down, but and he didn't lift many weights, but if he did, it just his tummy stick out. And I had a friend at McNeil Island. He did 65,000 sit-ups a day, and he couldn't get no shape turn because that's the way his body was. But he could get strong. He was a weightlifter. You ever notice in physical fitness, some guys can do a couple of curls a day and something else, and that's it. Their neck get thick, and you think, man, what you doing for your neck? Nothing. It's just his gift. If he do a few things, that's his physical gift that Allah gave him. Okay, so now, how do you want to look physically in the future? Well, you can build that body. That's what bodybuilding is. How do you want to be in your mind? How do you want your spirit to be? Well, I want to be like this. I want to be where the white man can't do, say nothing to me. Pretty soon, that's the way you are. Well, you can talk about who you're talking to, sucker. Because that's the way you want to be. And so you say, I'm all right now. This white man is saying, I like myself. I like myself. And I remember one Iranian, I was listening to that cassette one time. He couldn't imagine what the white man was talking about. I said, don't worry, I'll take care of it. I'll tell you all what it means. He couldn't imagine. But he had the same thing. He didn't even know. In Iran, the people like white folks more than they do Iranians. So he had the same problem. He just didn't know how to understand it, you know. Okay, now, let's get back to this Liyaka Jazmiya. Physical fitness. Simple physical fitness program. Don't cost you a dime. If you do, they say, let me see, what's the difference? Cardiovascular, aerobic exercise, 50% reduction. Cardiovascular, 50% reduction. Now that's, let me see, general exercise program below higher levels of cardio, physical fitness are associated with 50% reduction. Good God. That means you reduce your chances 50% with modest exercise. Then hypertension, high blood pressure. Now remember, what the white man do to you, everything he do to you is to produce these things. If he want to feed you pork and stuff like that, and all that food they have and all that salt in it is to produce high blood pressure, hypertension. And he keep you having to pay bills, so the bill is so high this month, you've got hypertension. Right? Everything, he got a police with a light, catch you on the camera over here where I run by the swimming pool, doggone thing, catch people, everybody with that light almost sitting in the middle of the street, and here they come, zoop, and sometimes I'm sitting there for 2 minutes, go clack, 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 and catch all them people that's producing hypertension. Man, the kids' money is for college, they want me to pay $100. Right? What are they producing here? Do they have anything in the United States soothing, calming you down? Is it the television? When you watch TV, do you get calmed down and relaxed? When you watch the news, do you get calmed down and relaxed? Right?
The news produces hypertension.
Of course it do. It's horrible. The news is horrible. I mean, here we are, we want to do 2-3 good deeds. Man, this is a big job. You know, if they don't show nothing that says, oh, don't worry, it's not that big a job. Here's 2 or 3 things good going on. They don't ever show them, right? This is going to help you save the world. It ain't no world-saving program. All they do, China's not accepting any more garbage. So, you know, so now this is going on. Where are they dumping the garbage? And years ago, Sudan, they said, we hate Sudan, but we're going to send our nuclear waste over there, and it'll take 10,000 years to decompose. I said, man, if you wasn't a Muslim and a studier, you would go crazy. Hypertension, regular physical fitness. Now, there's a 50% reduction. Now, they talk about aerobic exercises, but if you combine aerobic and anaerobic is weightlifting, and aerobic is running. You know, things are doing a lot of stuff to get you breathing hard. Anaerobic is lifting weights and stuff, making you stronger. The best routine is a combination. Cross training, they used to call it. I don't know if they still do. Cross training, you do running, you do weightlifting, so your body gets strong. Now, also imagine you want to picture yourself at 70 years old, 80 years old, 90 years old and 100 years old. So you have to plan your, you may not make it, but might as well plan your routine. You see? So, I was running yesterday, I said, I think I can keep this up for another 10 years at this pace. So at 83, I want to be just about where it is now. And that'll be fine. Maybe at 93, we might just cut back a little bit. But who cares? You know, it feels so good. You're just planning. You becoming something. You already what you are, but you want to look ahead. Just like you want to save your money. You want to save your body. Now, what's more important, your money or your body? So if you was blind, how much money would you give to see? You got $100 million. How much would you give to see? 99 million or 99.5 million or the whole thing? Everything. Guarantee you're going to see. He said, well, how much you got? Well, you got 100 million. Well, could you leave me about 10,000 just to have a little money to take the rest? But of course, I'm asking you to be a nice guy. Just for a couple thousand dollars just to get by. But you give it all up, right? If you can't walk, how much would you give to walk? That's the thing too, when you're exercising and you're running, this is what dicker is very important. Thank God that I can run. Thank God I can walk, man. Now look at these trees and look at these. Now they got some turkeys. I don't know whether they spotted them, put them turkeys out there. But the last 10 years?
Yeah, I mean, they used to be out there when I was running the trail. So
okay,
they've been out
right,
there for a while.
They got turkeys in Oakland, too. Now, I've been up in Oakland for 55 years, and I didn't see them until a few years ago. I don't know where they came from. But, hey, I started seeing them. I said, well, welcome. Maybe they transplanted them. But who cares, you know? The point is, that you're out there, you're grateful, you're thankful, and you're appreciative that you can do that. Now, all the time, you're breathing fresh air. Boy, that is semi-fresh air right here. But your lungs is opening up. What happened if you sit there watching TV, the big meal, you sit there, and you start drooling at the mouth, and you do that for a few years, and pretty soon your energy is gone, because the more weight you pick up, the harder it is to walk, right? And all that stuff, physical fitness. After spiritual fitness, physical fitness is next. Hey, because the Hadith is saying, make use of your health before becoming sick. So, now, about strokes, they said 20% reduction in strokes just for half an hour, 20 minutes to a half an hour of physical fitness, of activity. In 1 hour, they say 27% reduction. Now, they use terms like 3 to 5 times a week, which in the marathon days, they didn't consider you as a runner unless you ran 3 times a week. And they felt that 4 times was the best, to run 4 times a week. But when you're young, you're kind of ridiculous, so you run 7 days a week because you're getting high. The longer you run, you get high. So they tell you, I just smoke no more, but just smoke a half a joint. You said, if I smoke a whole joint, I'll smoke half of it and set it down that night and get up in the morning, light that boy up, something happened to it, just like the food get good. I don't know. They all smoke much weed, but I mean, seemed like it would enhance or something. I don't know. You know when you mix all them vegetables together? They do with chili. Right. It tastes better after a day or so. Sometimes people just light that boy, take a few hits, and set it down. Then in the morning, first thing, light that boy up. And then that's what they would say. I don't know why they smoke weed. But you know, physical fitness gets you higher. I brought this little thing today because I used to take them on trips when I on a plane. You know, you're going to be up there 14 hours. And these things really work. They're good. So for the last week, a couple weeks, I've been running again. So right after prayer, or if I get up early enough, super early, I do these exercises with these things. I put them on everything, and I can do, you know, all this stuff they pull in, you know. You can do chest stuff, you know, I mean, and you can do curls and all that stuff, and they're really nice. And when you get older, that's wonderful. And guess what you're doing? You're warming up your body. And when you're younger, you don't have to warm nobody. You just jump right up and just float on away. But after a while, man, does it feel good just to take 15 minutes, 20 minutes, to do a whole set of physical fitness, little light stuff. You're going to do your real workout later. But then, when you got to walk upstairs, you don't have to hold on. You know, because when you get older, until you, by the time people see you, you turning flips and everything. But when you first get up out of that bed, you know what I mean, after being just laying there all them hours, hey man, and you get a certain age, you just be stiff, nice and rested. But then the exercises, years ago, just push-ups would help, but after a while, you gotta do, you know, you wanna do the first set, you gotta do girl push-ups, you know, the ones on your knees. Yeah, because you don't wanna put too, tell the truth, when you get old, you put too much pressure on your muscles, they begin to sprung some muscle. So later on, you can put all that iron. Remember that iron out about last year? I had enough of that. But I hadn't lifted no heavy iron, I don't know when, man. I said, I'm going to lift iron, and I was wrangling. I mean, it had iron on it. But you had to start with one of them quarters, two quarters. You can't
gradual.
Yeah, just right. And then after a while, you're way up there.